So good morning, everyone. Okay, now here you can see that one girl is dancing, and in the other picture you can see a beautiful handwriting. Okay, so to achieve any of the skill, what you need to do? Yes, as you have told me that we need to practice. We need to practice a lot, and then only we get mastery over some of the other skill which you want to learn. Okay, now the next. Here you can see that the picture of two things, that is one side you can see the noodles and the second side you can see the what? Great Wall of China. Now this both the specialty of one of the country. Okay, kindly type in the chat box, what is the name of this country? From where these two things belongs to? Yes, absolutely right. It belongs to the China. Okay, noodles and as well as a Chinese food item. And Great Wall of China is in one of the famous things for belongs to China. Okay, of China. Now the China is our neighboring country. We have so many neighboring countries like the Pakistan, like the Nepal, like the Bhutan, then Myanmar, and then Bangladesh, and then Sri Lanka. So these all are the what? These are all are our neighboring country. No, okay, students. Yes. So now we are going to study about this story. First of all, open your textbook. If you have textbook in front of yourself, open it. And I'm going to read this story. You need to pay attention in each and every line. Okay? Neighboring means what? That country which are near to us. Okay, like India is a country, right? Near to the this are India, the country which are situated is known as neighboring country. जो कंट्री हमारे बाजू में है, जैसे आपके घर के बाजू में नेबर है, राइट, वैसे ही हमारे इंडिया कंट्री के बाजू में भी जो नेबरिंग कंट्री है, जो बाजू के देश है, उनको हम नेबरिंग कंट्री कहते हैं. पड़ोसी देश मतलब नेबरिंग कंट्री. ओके, लाइक चाइना एंड पाकिस्तान. एब्सोल्युटली राइट निमिश. ओके, now the story is related to long long ago in a far away China. There lived a archer called as Chen Yaozi. Okay, now the Yaozi was an archer. Now who is archer? Archer, a person having a skill, a great skill of using bow and arrow. Okay, so he was in great mastery over doing the archery, hit the target from long distance. So do you think anyone can? Okay, fine. So Yaozi was a great archer, skilled archer. He could perform a wonderful feat of archery. He could hit the target precisely at the what? At the center, even when it is placed in a far distance. He likes to show off his skills. He likes to show off his skills and admiring the crowd. So he was a great archer and he had a mastery over performing art of archery in front of his many admirers. Okay, now the next what happened? So in that crowd, one old man was standing, but he was not praising Yaozi. Now what? Why he was not praising Yaozi? Because he said, as per him, that it's only matter of practice. Now everybody was praising the skill of and the admirers. Okay, and he noticed that the old man standing at the back. Who noticed? Yaozi noticed. Yaozi noticed that the old man standing back, carrying gourds of oil, were hanging on a long cane. Okay, these are the gourds of oil. Okay, let's see the meaning of this gourd. So these gourds are the dry grass or the hard cover of fruit having a hard skin. And earlier in the ancient time, it was used to store the liquid in it. Okay. So this oil, he was an oil seller. Everybody was admiring, everybody was clapping, but this old man was standing and not doing anything. And he just stood there and nodding his head and said, it's just a matter of practice. What the old man said? Old man said, it's just a matter of practice. The whatever the Yaozi is performing in the front of people, okay, it's just a matter of practice. There is no wow factor in it. Okay, now Yaozi was annoyed. Annoyed, he was gotten angry. Okay, annoyed means getting angry or feeling some of the disturb, annoyed. And are you a nacho yourself? Do you think anyone can do what I can do with my bow and arrows? Now what the Yauzi said? Yauzi said, what do you think? Are you an archer yourself? Are you an archer? Do you know that how much practice it required? Okay. Do you think that anybody can do whatever I can do with this bow and arrow? Okay. The skill which I have, the same skill anybody have, it's, do you think it's so easy? So here the oil seller said very politely, no, sir. The old man replied, I'm not an archer and I don't doubt your skill. I said, was everything is a matter of practice. Now what, sir, what the old man said? Very politely. Okay, here the Yauzi was angry, but the old man was polite. And what he said? That yes, sir, I feel like yes, do you have skill. I have doubt about it. But what I want to say that it's only a matter of practice. Now Chen Yauzi became very angry. What do you know about and you pass such a thoughtless comment on other people? Who are you? Now here, Yauzi got some of the upset and got very angry. And he said that, who are you to pass such a thoughtless comment? What? Why you are passing this comment that it's only a matter of practice? Now why the Yauzi got angry? Because Yauzi was boosted up with the mindset that I am very great. And I'm a great archer. I'm having such a brilliant skill. Nobody have that. So he having such an ego in his mind. And that's the reason Yauzi got angry. And he even said that you are making thoughtless comment. Thoughtless comment means what, children? What is mean by this thoughtless comment? Thoughtless means when we speak without thinking. When we speak or utter a word without thinking or pass a comment without thinking. Whether it is right or wrong, good or bad, or reliable or not. Okay, so this kind of comments, this time kinds of words are considered as a thoughtless comments. So Yauzi said that to the old man that you are passing thoughtless comment on other people. Who are you? Now here the old man. Okay, now what the old man said that, please don't get angry, sir. I'm an oil seller. And you must have grass from the goats of oil. I feel these goats and oil and sell them. Over the years, I have achieved some skill in feeding the goats. And if you allow, I shall show it to him. You. Okay. Now here, the old man that I am oil seller and I'm selling from a long time. And even after selling a oil from a long time, I got one skill. If you permit me, what I'm going to do, I'm going to showcase my skill. Now here, then the Yauzi said, Round the Yauzi, and everyone was serious and curious to see that what happened next. Now the crowd was very serious to know that what is going to be happen next, what this oil seller is going to show us. Okay. Now archer, someone who shoot with the bow and arrow by making the balance. Now precisely means exactly. What is mean by precisely? Precisely means exactly at the decided target. Now, next meaning, gourds of oil means what? Container made up of from the dry, large fruit with the hard skin. Okay. In ancient time, people used to store oil in this because they don't have the vessels. Okay. Right now, we have bottles and so many things. Earlier, it was that the people used to store liquid in this type of gourds of oil. Okay, it was said to be. Now, where did the Chen Yauzi live? Now, in Australia, China, India, and Brazil. Answer me through with the help of chat box. Where did Yauzi live? In China. Absolutely right. Now, the next. What was Chen Yauzi? He was an archer, poet, farmer. What he was? A, B, C, D. He was an archer. Absolutely right, student. Now next. Then the oil seller started showing his skill. He placed the gourds of oil in the ground and he placed the small coin. Okay? This coin. You can see this coin. Now this coin, if you clearly see, then you can see here this coin having a hole. Okay, what this coin having? This coin having a very small hole in the middle. Okay, so he just placed this coin in the mouth of the god. Okay, gods of oil, you know that the container. So he placed the coin at the top of this container and started pouring the oil from a distance, from with the help of ladder. From here, he started pouring the oil. He started pouring the oil from a distance. Okay. Now you know that this hole is very small. Okay, which is there in the middle. Now, if you know, children, if you have ever placed the oil and the oil, it is very difficult to put the liquid inside the small mouth type bottles. Okay, but here the hole was very small and he just placed it all over it and started pouring the oil. After a while, when he just put up and out the coin and lifted up, no trace of oil couldn't be seen on it. So that coin was absolutely clean. There was no oil, a drop of oil, trace of oil at the top of this coin, and everything was very neat. Okay, which is very difficult. As have you ever tried to just pour oil inside the any bottle or vessel? It is very difficult. Many more times, one or two drop, or sometimes more than that, even the spoon of oil gets out of it. Okay, even this hole is so large, but here the hole is very small. But then too, that the oil seller got such a skill that even the trace of oil was not found at the top of the coin. So the people watching it were speechless with the wonder, but the old man only smiled and said, "It's just a matter of practice." Okay. Now here, after watching the skill of old man, that the Yaozi come to know that he is boosted of his knowledge, and his all anger got lost, and he smiled and said that because I have learned something new today, I will never be just be up to my skill. Okay. Now what is mean by utter? Utter means said. What is mean by speechless? Unable to speak. People who were watching. Now speechless means what? Whenever you're not able to pass any comment, or you think that you don't have words to express. So we say, I'm speechless. Sometimes we speechless because of the wonder, because of the good thing. And sometimes even speechless word is used to just say that I don't know that the work was so worst. Okay, I'm speechless. So speechless is used in both the conditions. Now, question and answer time. What was the reaction of people when the trace of oil couldn't be seen on the coin? People were happy. People were sad. People were speechless with wonder. Okay, tell me, what was the reaction of people? Happy. They were happy? No. They were speechless with wonder. They were not happy. They were speechless with wonder. Okay? The last option, option C is right. Okay? Option C is right. Now next. Next question is, what did the small coin have at the center? What did the small coin have at the center? A, number. B, picture. C, little hole. And D, name. What was the small coin having at the middle or at the center? C, hole. Absolutely right. Very good, student. Now, next question. What did the old man put on the mouth of the god? Lead, pen, or small coin? Absolutely right. See, small coin. Okay. So this story was clear to everybody? Okay.
So we are going to see the video related to this story for the clear idea. Watch this video carefully. Okay, students.
Feats of archery. Skilled means experienced or good at something. This. Long, long ago, in faraway China, there lived an archer called Chen Yaozi. He was a very skilled archer and could perform wonderful feats of archery. Skilled means experienced or good at something. Archer is someone who shoots arrows from a bow. Feats means achievements that require a lot of skill or strength, etc. He could hit the target precisely at the center, even when it was placed at a very long distance. Precisely means exactly. He liked to show off his skill to the admiring crowds that gathered around him. One day, he was practicing his skill in front of many admirers when he noticed an old man standing at the back. The man was carrying gourds of oil that were hanging from a long chain on his shoulder. Gourds means containers made from dried large fruit with a hard skin. All the other people were clapping their hands and praising Chen Yaozi. But this old man was quiet. He neither clapped nor uttered words of praise. Uttered means to give audible expression to or said. He just stood there, nodding his head and said, "It's just a matter of practice." To nod means to shake. Chen Yaozi was annoyed. "Are you an archer yourself? Do you think anyone can do what I can do with my bow and arrows?" Annoyed means angry. "No, sir," the old man replied. "I'm not an archer and I don't doubt your skill. All I said was, everything's a matter of practice." Chen Yaozi became very angry. "What do you know that you pass such thoughtless comments on other people? Who are you?" Thoughtless comment means a statement made without thinking. "Please don't get angry, sir. I'm an oil seller, as you must have guessed from the goats. Guessed means to form an estimate. Every day, I fill these goats with oil and sell them. Over the years, I have achieved some skill in filling the goats. If you allow, I'll show it to you." Growled Chen Yaozi. Everybody was curious to see what would happen next. Growled means to make a low, rough sound, usually in anger. Patiently, the old man set down an empty gourd on the ground. Then he put a small coin on the mouth of the gourd. In those days, small coins had a little hole at the center. Then the old man stood up, took some oil in his ladle and began to pour oil into the gourd from a height. Ladle is a long-handled spoon having a deep bowl for serving liquids. The oil went straight into the gourd through the hole in the coin. When the old man had finished filling up the gourd, he lifted up the coin.
Okay, now I hope that half of the story is clear to you. Yes or no? Yes, and later what happened, student? Later, everybody was shocked. And at the end, Yaozi come to know that he made a mistake. Okay, he should not be boosted up with his skill. Okay, now student, it's time to do the reading. Just open your... Okay, fine. Open your